Hi everyone, how are you doing? Hope you are doing well and welcome back again to Challenge Learning Turkish session 25. In this session, you are gonna learn how to negate future tense in Turkish. Okay, now let's see how it works. Now, let's start with a quick glance at negative form in Turkish. Negative suffixes used in future negative tense are ma or me in Turkish. Don't forget this. They are attached to the verb root based on the verb root's last vowel letters. Future tense suffixes after these negative suffixes are ecek or acak. Again, they are added depending on the vowel harmony rule. So, for me negative suffix, it will be ecek, and for ma negative suffix, it will be acak. As the negative suffixes ma or me ends with vowels, as you see here, a and e are the last and ending vowel letters of the negative suffixes, and the future tense suffixes ecek or acak again begins with vowels e and a, as you see, a buffer y letter is always inserted between the negative suffix and future suffixes. Why? Because as I explained here, negative suffixes ends with vowel letters and future tense suffixes starts with vowel letters. That requires a buffer y letter in between. And naturally, personal suffixes are added to the end after tense suffixes. For example, you can see here a sample verb. So our verb is gelmek, to come. To make it into negative form, after the verb root gel, so depending on the last vowel letter, e here, e requires me. Negative suffix me, and the vowel letter of the negative suffix e requires future tense suffix ecek. So gelme, eceğim. So there are two vowels, so we require a buffer y letter in between, and it becomes gelmeyecek. So k will change to soft g, and person suffix for first person singular pronoun, ben, I. Ben gelmeyeceğim. Okay, now let's see the structure, how it works. So in the first place, there is verb root, which is followed by negative suffixes, either as ma or me. Then we need a buffer y letter. Why? Because future tense suffixes following always start with vowel, either acak or ecek. And finally, personal suffix comes to the end. For example, our sample verb here is okumak. Okumak. So the verb root ends with vowel and it is the last vowel letter. So u requires negative suffix ma, this last vowel. So and ma requires future tense suffix a because of the vowel letter of a. And in between, since the negative suffix and the future tense suffix starts with vowel, in between we need a buffer y letter and it becomes okumayacak, will not read. Now let's see the table chart here. So how suffixes are added to the verb root. So this column shows us last vowel of the verb root, because depending on the last vowel of the verb root, we will add either ma negative suffix or me negative suffix. So here two-way vowel harmony rule works. So the vowel letters are separated into two groups. So for the last vowels of the verb root a, e, o, u, the negative suffix will be ma. And remember from the previous slide, ma requires acak future tense suffix. And for ben subject pronoun, it takes the form of ma ya cağım. So you can see buffer ye letter here. So here refers to the personal suffix. For second person singular pronoun sen, so again ma ya cağsın. The only thing changing here is the personal suffixes, as you may notice here. So ma ya cağım for ben, Maya Jackson for sen. For third person singular pronoun he or she or it, remember there is never ever personal suffix following, so just Maya Jack. For first person plural pronoun biz, it is Maya Jacks. Remember, since the person suffix is starts with vowel k, changes to soft g. Like for ben subject here, k again changed to soft g here for person suffix. For second person plural pronoun, it is mayacaksınız. For third person plural, mayacaklar. Remember, these are the form for the verb roots, including one of these vowel letters as the last vowel in the verb root. And second line, so if the last vowel of the verb root is e, e, ö, or ü, then we will add the negative suffix me instead of ma this time, and this me requires acak future tense suffix instead of acak, and it takes the form of, together with person suffix here for ben subject, it is meyeceğim for sen, meyeceksin for third person singular, no person suffix, meyecek for first person plural, meyeceğiz for second person plural, meyeceksiniz for third person plural, meyecekler. Okay, now let's do some practice here. Our sample verb is yazmak infinitive form, and we will take the verb root yaz. So ben anneme yarın mektup yazmayacağım. Remember, this is the negative form. We covered the affirmative form in the last slide. So for this reason, after verb root yaz, there comes negative suffix because of the last vowel a. Remember, first group, first line, a, ı, o, u. So this requires negative suffix ma, which is followed by buffer ye, because a, this a of the negative suffix requires acak future tense suffix, and person suffix ım for first person singular pronoun. Ben anneme yarın mektup yazmayacağım. For second person singular pronoun, sen annene yarın mektup yazmayacaksın. Remember what I told you before, just personal suffixes changes here in the negative form. So again, verb root yaz is followed by negative suffix after buffer ye, so future tense suffix comes in and the personal suffix and the sentence. Sen annene yarın mektup yazmayacaksın. Okay, so third person singular pronoun he or she. O annesine yarın mektup yazmayacak. No person suffix comes in here. Biz annemize yarın mektup yazmayacağız. Biz annemize to our mom yarın tomorrow mektup a letter yazmayacağız. We not write. Siz annenize yarın mektup yazmayacaksınız. Siz annenize yarın mektup yazmayacaksınız. Third person plural. Onlar annelerine yarın mektup yazmayacaklar. Or remember third person plural would take optional personal suffix, so we can omit this personal suffix and treat it like third person singular, just saying onlar annelerine yarın mektup yazmayacak. Satın almak, to buy. Bu sene mezun olmazsan, conditional sentence, sana araba satın almayacağım. In the meaning of to buy, so we can omit the satın part of the verb. We can just say almayacağım because it is understood from the context. For that reason we can omit it or use it. So bu sene, this year, so condition part of the sentence, bu sene, this year mezun, graduate olmazsan, mezun olmazsan, if you don't graduate this year, sana, to you, araba, a car, satın almayacağım, will not buy, satın almak, buy, satın almayacağım, will not buy. Bu sene mezun olmazsan sana araba almayacağım. Now, let's see the just almak. Remember, satın almak is to buy, almak to take. Ben bu akşam çocukları okuldan almayacağım. Ben bu akşam çocukları okuldan almayacağım. I am not going to take the kids from the school this evening. Ben, I, bu akşam, this evening, çocukları, the kids, okuldan, with ablative suffix, okuldan, from the school, almayacağım, not going to take. Olmak can translate either as to be or to happen or become. Hava gelecek hafta karlı olmayacak. Hava, the weather, gelecek hafta, next week, karlı, snowy olmayacak, will not be. Karlı olmayacak, will not be snowy. Olmak again. Büyüyünce doktor olmayacağım, öğretmen olacağım. A good example giving both the affirmative and negative form here. So büyüyünce when I grow, doktor, a doctor olmayacağım. I am not going to be, olmayacağım, not going to, olmayacağım, I am not going to be. But, however, öğretmen olacağım. I am going to be a teacher. Öğretmen, a teacher olacağım. Together with person suffix. I am going to be. Büyüyünce doktor olmayacağım. Öğretmen olacağım. İptal etmek. Sen yarınki toplantını iptal etmeyeceksin. Sen yarınki toplantını iptal etmeyeceksin. Sen you yarınki toplantını your tomorrow meeting iptal etmeyeceksin. Will not cancel. İptal, cancel. İptal etmeyeceksin. Will not cancel. Ziyaret etmek. O bizi bugün ziyaret etmeyecek. O, he or she, bizi, us, bugün, today, ziyaret, visit etmeyecek. Ziyaret etmeyecek, will not visit. İtaat etmek or sinonimli uymak to obey. Biz senin emirlerine uymayacağız. Remember, biz is omittable here. We can skip it. Why? Because of these personal suffixes. Because they already refer to the subject pronoun. So for that reason we can either use it or omit it. So biz, we, senin, your, senin emirlerin, your commands, senin emirlerine, to your commands, uymayacağız, will not obey. Biz senin emirlerine uymayacağız. Öğrenmek, o bu gerçeği öğrenmeyecek. Since this is a third person singular pronoun, there is no personal suffix used here. He or she, o, bu, this, gerçeği, fact, bu gerçeği, this fact, öğrenmeyecek, will not learn. Gülmek, artık kimseye gülmeyeceğim. So remember, hidden pronoun is first person subject pronoun, ben. Ben artık kimseye gülmeyeceğim. So ben, I, artık anymore kimseye anyone gülmeyeceğim, will not laugh at. So kimseye at anyone gülmeyeceğim, will not laugh. Buluşmak. Yarın Tom ile buluşmayacağım. Yarın Tom ile buluşmayacağım. So again the subject pronoun is first person singular. Ben buluşmayacağım. I am not meeting. Not going to meet. So ben, I, yarın, tomorrow, Tom ile, with Tom, buluşmayacağım. Not going to meet. Başlamak, either to start or begin. O, yarın İşe başlamayacak. Third person singular. O, he or she, yarın, tomorrow, işe, iş, work, işe, to work, başlamayacak, will not begin. Uyumak, to sleep. O, bu gece uyumayacak. Gece vardiyası var. O, he or she, bu gece, tonight, uyumayacak, not going to sleep. So o, he or she bu gece, tonight, uyumayacak, is not going to sleep. Gece vardiyası var. He or she has a night shift. So night shift, gece vardiyası var. He or she has. Beklemek, biz sizi daha fazla beklemeyeceğiz. Biz, we, sizi, you, daha fazla, longer, no longer, beklemeyeceğiz. So, we will no longer wait. Müsaade etmek, müsaade etmek, colloquially, sana bunu yapmana müsaade etmeyeceğim. Sana bunu yapmana müsaade etmeyeceğim. Sana bunu yapmana müsaade etmeyeceğim. Sana, you, bunu, this, bunu yapmana, to do this, müsaade etmeyeceğim. Will not allow. Okay guys, thank you again for being with me during this session. And again, I hope you have found this lesson enjoyable. And again, let's close the session with the idiom of the session. It is başını kuma gömmek. Okay, it translates as bury one's head in the sand. Başını kuma gömmek. Again, thank you for listening me, and I hope you have enjoyed the lesson. If so, please don't forget to click on like and subscribe to the channel. Gelecek slide'da görüşmek üzere. Hoşça kalın.